The rankings are determined by cities, where the odds are highest of someone becoming a victim of violent crime. Here are the top 10 most violent U.S. cities in 2021. Number 10. Benton Harbor, Michigan. The population of Benton Harbor in 2019 was 9,741. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 50. There were 193 violent crimes in 2019, which is about 1 every 2 days. 3 of these were murders, 20 were rapes, 19 robberies, and 151 assaults. Benton Harbor used to be the largest fresh fruit port in the U.S. However, those days are long gone. Deindustrialization has resulted in factories and processing plants being abandoned or torn down and being replaced by vacant lots. Benton Harbor became a hub for the Midwest crack trade beginning in the 1980s, further adding to the litany of issues facing the city and its residents, which included the mismanagement of the economy by the local government, resulting in overdraft fees in the six-figure range, plus millions owed to the IRS. In the last 5 years, Benton Harbor's population declined by almost 2%, even as the U.S. population grew by close to 4%. More than 45% of people here live in poverty, while the national average is 10%. The per capita income of its residents is roughly $14,197, compared to $34,103 for the rest of the nation. About 60% of its population do not have access to a car and is on some form of public assistance. Only 8% of its citizens have completed a bachelor's degree or higher, 4 times lower than the rest of the country. Number 9. West Memphis, Arkansas. The population of West Memphis in 2019 was 24,402. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 50. There were 485 violent crimes in 2019, which is more than 1 per day. 8 of these were murders, 33 were rapes, 57 robberies, and 387 assaults. Even though violent crime overall has decreased by nearly 20% since 2012, unemployment is still high in West Memphis at 11%, with 26% living in poverty. The median income per person is $20,249, 40% below the rest of the U.S. You are more than 6 times likely to get murdered and assaulted in West Memphis than in other parts of the country. Also, your chance of getting raped are more than tripled. On January 1st, 2019, new Mayor Marco McClendon said he wants to create a land bank in West Memphis, focusing on the city's blight and abandoned properties, adding jobs and lowering the crime rate. Hopefully, this will create some positive changes in the community. Number 8. Opa-locka, Florida. The population of Opa-locka in 2019 was 15,887. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 49. There were 324 violent crimes in 2019, which is almost 1 per day. 11 of these were murders, 10 were rapes, 67 robberies, and 236 assaults. Opa-locka, one of Florida's poorest cities and infamous for the triangles of crime, which was a haven for drug trafficking and criminal activities, has been on the verge of bankruptcy for quite some time now. Citywide budget cuts have resulted in reduced salary for police, with some positions being eliminated entirely. Some cops are wearing ripped uniforms and driving donated cars with more than 100,000 miles on them, which need constant repairs. The cars also don't have crime scene tape, first aid kits, jumper cables, and other equipment needed by officers on the road. The police headquarters building is so rife with leaks and mold that officers move their operations to City Hall. It's no surprise then that over 91% of crimes reported were not solved. Due to these developments, the police chief was relieved of duty in August 2020. An investigation showed the police lacked the ability to respond to residents in a professional manner, and that over half of the officers reported morale in the department was terrible. The former police chief is suing the city, alleging that mainly corruption and political interference are the reason for his firing, particularly due to an incident where he issued a citation to the mayor's cousin. The case continues. Only 69% of Opa-locka residents have a high school or higher education level. The rest of the U.S. is 88%. 41% of the population live in poverty, and the average income per person is $14,320, which is nearly 60% less than normal. Number 7. Gallup, New Mexico. The population of Gallup in 2019 was 21,493. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 49. There were 437 violent crimes in 2019, totaling more than 36 per month. One of these was a murder, 20 were rapes, 84 robberies, and 332 assaults. Historical unemployment rates at more than double the national average, alcohol and drug abuse running rampant, along with the supposedly soft justice system, has helped Gallup be the first city from New Mexico to join the list. Income levels per person are 30% below normal, with 28% of residents living in poverty. Gallup has one of the largest proportions of citizens married with children and in poverty at 54%, while also having one of the largest proportions of unmarried citizens with children and in poverty at 51%. Unplanned pregnancies account for a much higher percentage of residents under 18 years old than in the rest of the country. The rate of people under 65 who don't have health insurance is double compared to other cities in the U.S. Number 6. Highland Park, Michigan. The population of Highland Park in 2019 was 10,775. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 48. There were 222 violent crimes in 2019, equaling more than one every 2 days. Two of these were murders, 16 were rapes, 43 robberies, and 161 assaults. Highland Park is the poorest American city by a wide margin, thanks to a combination of poverty, deindustrialization, crime, unemployment, lackluster law enforcement, shootings, drugs, and urban blight. Highland Park's average annual household income is $18,474, nearly $44,000 lower than the U.S. average. It is the only city in the nation in which most households earn less than $20,000 a year, leading to a 46% poverty rate, one of the highest rates nationwide. Only 10% of inhabitants hold a bachelor's degree, and only 46% of homes have a broadband subscription, in contrast to the 82% U.S. average. The economic situation in Highland Park has worsened in recent years. From 2012 to 2017, employment opportunities has dropped more than 15%, with the city's 5-year average unemployment rate of 13%, well above the comparable U.S. rate of 4%. Number 5. Alexander City, Alabama. The population of Alexander City in 2018 was 14,317. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 47. There were an estimated 305 violent crimes in 2019, which is about 6 per week. Estimates are based on 2018 crime rates, as 2019 figures were not provided to the FBI. The city's economy was centered around the textile industry, but with Russell Corporation, the largest employer in the city, being sold and operations moving offshore, more than 6,500 jobs have been lost, and most of the manufacturing has ceased, with a majority of buildings empty. 21% of people living in poverty, with a median household and per capita income 40% below average. Future job growth over the next 10 years is predicted to be 20%, which is lower than the U.S. average of 33.5%. In 2015, the city and its chief of police were sued after plaintiffs alleged that from 2013 to 2015, the police arrested and detained at least 194 defendants who were unable to pay municipal court-imposed fines and costs. In 2017, the city reached a settlement where the plaintiffs received $680,000. In Alexander City, you are more likely to be a victim of aggravated assault, as it's more than 8 times the national average. Number 4. Muskegon Heights, Michigan. The population of Muskegon Heights in 2019 was 10,736. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 45. There were 236 violent crimes in 2019, which is more than 1 every 2 days. 5 of these were murders, 17 were rapes, 36 robberies, and 178 assaults. Perched near the shores of Lake Michigan, Muskegon Heights marks the 3rd Michigan city to make the list. Like the majority of the state, the city has suffered due to deindustrialization, drug use, incompetent local government, and in the second half of 2020, employment opportunities have dropped by 2/3. Just 7% of adults have a bachelor's degree or higher, one of the smallest bachelor's degree attainment rates of any U.S. city. More than 36% of people live below the poverty line, with a per capita income of $14,859, one of the lowest in the country, and a typical household earning just $30,795 a year, less than half the U.S. median. Number 3. Bessemer, Alabama. The population of Bessemer in 2018 was 26,472. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 33. There were an estimated 790 violent crimes in 2019, which is more than 2 per day. Estimates are based on 2018 crime rates, as 2019 figures were not provided to the FBI. Bessemer once had a bustling economy and was a hub of manufacturing and ore mining, but as these industries dried up or moved elsewhere, unemployment rose, and with it, violent crime. Unemployment rates are significantly higher than the national average, while the service industry jobs that have replaced manufacturing jobs in these communities often pay measly wages that can't provide a decent standard of living. More than a quarter of people in Bessemer living in poverty, and the median income per person and household is just over half the U.S. average. Number 2. Anniston, Alabama. The population of Anniston in 2018 was 21,287. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 29. There were an estimated 731 violent crimes in 2019, equaling almost 2 per day. Estimates are based on 2018 crime rates, as 2019 figures were not provided to the FBI. The economy in Anniston hasn't been the same since Fort McClellan closed down, and many civilians who worked at the base lost their jobs or don't make anywhere near the income they used to. From 1990 to 2000, about 8,000 people left the city. Anniston's violent crime rate is nearly 9 times higher than the rest of the country, even though there has been a decline the last couple of years. Poverty level is at 27%, with one of the worst opioid user rates in the country, and 18% of the population under 65 having a disability, more than double the U.S. average. In 2003, a chemical maker, Monsanto, settled a pair of lawsuits brought by more than 20,000 residents of Anniston for $700 million. After it was proved the company continued polluting ground outside the plant, even though it knew it was spreading cancer-causing pollutants, which continues to affect many residents to this day. Number 1. Española, New Mexico. The population of Española in 2019 was 10,329. The chance of becoming a victim of violent crime here is 1 in 29. There were an estimated 361 violent crimes in 2019, equaling almost 1 per day. Estimates are based on 2018 crime rates, as 2019 figures were not provided to the FBI. 68 miles northeast of the capital Albuquerque, is Española, the self-proclaimed lowrider capital of the world and the title holder of the most violent city in the U.S. for 2021. Local government have argued that the high violent crime rate is caused by the large number of visitors from surrounding communities. However, what's certain is the narcotics trade, drug addiction, and alcohol abuse are big problems in Española. The public school system in New Mexico is thought to be one of the worst in the U.S., and in this city, the public teachers are required to undergo mandatory drug testing due to the epidemic sweeping the area. More than a third of people make less than $15,000 a year, less than half the average, with 24% living in poverty. Reportedly, real estate prices, cost of living is comparable to bigger cities in New Mexico, even though the standards and infrastructure are not up to par, which makes life more difficult for the struggling.